Hello everybody, welcome to Pinnacle Online Coaching Classes. In this video lecture, we are going to do close test. Very important topic for SSC CGL Tier 2 paper. The English section, it will have quite a few questions ranging from 25 to 30 you will get from this section. Since it is a very important topic, therefore Pinnacle is making a complete series of 20 video lectures on this topic, close test, and this is part 3 of the lecture. In part 1, I have already discussed with you what kind of close tests are expected for SSC, how you should tackle them, what you should exactly know, how to identify the tone of the passage, all that has been discussed. And now we are moving on to part 3. In part 3, I am going to deal with how grammar-based knowledge is to be used for close test. Very important. This series on close test, these 20 video lectures which are being made, they are part of our Job Assure Part 2 program. And what is the Job Assure Part 2 program? Job Assure Part 2 program is a specially designed day-wise program. After studying the entire syllabus, after studying all the papers, experts have designed this program for you, in which you are given a schedule on daily basis. What is to be done, how it is to be done, exercises given, all the rules and everything is given. And after that, at the end of the day, even a test is conducted so that you know exactly how your preparation is progressing. All these video lectures, they are a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program. Now let's begin with how you should use grammar based knowledge for your close tests, for solving close tests. Let us use grammar related knowledge. A lot of students tell me that, ma'am, I know all the rules. If you ask me all the rules, I know them. If you ask me to do spot the error sentence improvement, I can do that. But I do not know how to apply my knowledge about grammar in case of close tests and para jumbles. Now one by one, I shall take different sections of grammar and I shall discuss with them. Now if it is grammar related blank in the close test, then it could be related to preposition, it could be related to adverb, it could be related to noun, adjective, etc. See, it is always handy to know, it is always useful to know. For example, if I tell you a word, I say add, which part of speech it is, you will say, ma'am, it is an article. If I say beautiful and I ask you which part of speech it is, you will say it is adjective. So even if you know it this way, which part of speech a particular word is, definitely they can be used for different parts of speech in different sentences, but still you should have a rough knowledge. If I give you a word, you should be able to tell me it is which part of speech. Now for example, if I ask you visit, which part of speech it is, you will say, ma'am, it is a verb. But when I say it was a pleasant visit, it was an expected visit, then in that case visit becomes a noun. It changes from sentence to sentence definitely, but what is it mostly used as, that you should be aware of. Now here, prepositions. Prepositions following a noun, adjective or adverb. Prepositions following an, in your close test, if it is a grammar based close test, definitely there will be 2 to 3 blanks which will be related to prepositions. This is one of the most used topics of grammar in close test, and a lot of students, they are not comfortable with the usage of preposition. Now preposition following a noun, adjective or adverb. Now here I have given an example. What is it? Is it good at handicraft, good at English, or good in English? A lot of students while speaking, they say he is very good in English, but it is not actually good in English. Good in is incorrect. What you have to say, you have to say is good at. So you could be given a blank where the preposition needs to be filled in, and your 4 options could be at, in, of, beside. So you should know the correct usage of the prepositions, how they are to be used. Notice for, notice of. Notice of, he took notice of my dirty dress. But notice for, he received a notice for his bad behavior. Notice from, the management. So this way you should know where which preposition is to be used and how it will alter the meaning of the sentence. Extremely important for close test. If you ask me out of grammar, which is the most important topic for close test, I will say 101% it is prepositions. Next is adverb. Next is adverb. Let's take an example here. He moved to a new job 2 years ago. Now this is my sentence. Now here, he moved to a new job 2 years dash. You could be given here to fill up. Okay. Moved to a new job 2 years dash. Did he move 2 years earlier, 2 years ago, 2 years before, or 2 years early? Now here in this sentence we have to use he moved to a new job 2 years earlier, 2 years ago, 2 years early, or 2 years before. Now all these four options have been given to you. Now in this sentence we have to use ago. Please remember that whenever a time frame is given, 2 years, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 2 weeks, 6 months, etc., with them only one adverb is to be used, which is ago. Before is used in case of two incidents. Before making a video lecture, I prepare for it. Before going to the examination center, check whether you have carried all the important documents or not. When there are two incidents, early is the early part of something. So, and here we have earlier is used in a case of comparison. So here you should know that we have to use ago. You should know the right usage of a preposition or adverb. And sometimes, you know, in the blank, you will see it. See, suppose A or an is given. You will immediately know that a noun has to be filled up. That's why I'm saying that you should know whether this particular part of speech, it belongs to which one. It belongs to which one, which part of grammar, that is important to know. Now, let's move on to the next one. Here we have connectors. Now here we have connectors. Connectors connecting different parts of sentences together. First he called me, dash he offered me a fresh proposal and asked me to think over it. Then he called me, here it will be then he offered me, than he offered me, when he offered me, or while he offered me. Here you need to see that the sentence is in past tense. We have called here, we have offered here. My sentence is in past tense. Than is used in case of comparison when two things are being compared. Here there is no comparison. Okay. When is used with simple past and while is used with continuous tense. There is no continuous tense here, so this will be eliminated. There is no comparison, so this will be eliminated. Here then is going to be offered, because here we are talking with reference to time. First he was called and then he offered me a fresh proposal. A is going to be the right answer. You need to know the right usage of words. After connectors, let us talk about relative pronouns. You could be given such a blank in your close test also. Sanjeev dash, I met 2 years ago, used to work with us at Pinnacle. Sanjeev dash, I met 2 years ago, used to work with us at Pinnacle. Remember your rules about relative pronoun. In relative pronoun, what have we done? We have done that in case of persons, two relative pronouns, who and whom are used, right? Which is used when there is a choice, and generally it is used for things. That is used for non-living things. And that can also be used in those situations where an adjective of superlative degree is being used. Now here we are restricted to only two choices, who or whom, because there is no word of superlative degree here. Now, in this particular sentence, please remember, we can either use who or whom, but you should immediately see the word which has been used after the relative pronoun, which is I. Now, I is a pronoun. If my relative pronoun is followed by a pronoun, then in that situation, I have to use whom. So, Sanjeev, whom I met 2 years ago, used to work with us at Pinnacle. This is the right answer. Whom is going to be used? Relative pronoun, whom. You should know the right usage of relative pronoun, connectors, prepositions, adverbs, etc. Next, is there a comparative or superlative involved? If there is a comparative or superlative involved, then you should be able to select the right form of the adjective in the comparative or in the superlative. Now here, SSC CGL is one of the dash exams held in India. Now we are talking about one of the. And the is generally used before the superlative degree related to the rules of adjectives. So here the superlative degree is going to be used. And what is the superlative degree? Is most tough the superlative degree of tough? For this you even need to know the superlative degree of tough. No, most tough is incorrect. Sometimes students use words like most toughest also, which is highly incorrect. Toughest is already in the superlative form, so why use most? SSC CGL is one of the toughest exams held in India. Here, toughest is going to be used. A pronoun, either subject or object. Now here, sometimes you may be given a blank, and there you might have to decide whether you have to fill in a pronoun, whether you have to fill in a subject, or you have to fill in an object. You might have to decide that also. Now let us take this sentence. The family was worried about the missing plane, but dash was difficult to get any information from the authorities in this particular sentence. Now, a pronoun, either subject or object, what has to be filled in? The family was worried about the missing plane, but they was difficult. Now here it is they, so with they I cannot use was, because they is plural and this is singular, so they gets eliminated. With was I can neither use there, there is plural, so this gets eliminated. I have to restrict my choice to it and its. Now, but dash was difficult, its was difficult, this is incorrect, but it was difficult to get any information from the authorities. In this case, option A is the right one. You should know which pronoun is paired with which kind of noun. It is very, very important to know. This was about your pronouns. You should even be able to identify whether it is an active or passive voice. If it is in passive voice and different verbs are given to you, then only the one which is in the third form has to be picked up. These kind of things you must remember while doing your close test. An article or some kind of a determiner. There might be some blanks where some kind of an article or determiner will be used. Now here, these days I am so busy with my videos that I have dash time for anything else. That I have none time, that I have any time, that I have none time, or that I have no time. This word no is always going to be followed by a noun. I have no money. I have no classes today. I have no time. I have no dress to wear to the party. I have no buddy waiting at home for me. So here, no is going to be filled because we have time here. It can't be none time. Generally, this none which is given here, either it is going to be singular or it is going to be followed by of the. So if we had of the followed by a plural noun or pronoun, then this would have been correct. But in this particular case, no is going to be used. Some blanks might even require you to fill in an auxiliary verb, and auxiliary verb will be generally in relation to the subject. Here we have, they dash waiting for the bus when they heard the explosion. Now the sentence is in which tense? We have a past tense here, heard. Heard is in the past tense. So here, have cannot be used because it is in the present tense. We have they, so a plural word has to be filled up here, and was is in the singular. We have to choose between were and had. Now here, continuous tense is going to be used, so were is going to be used. This way, your different kind of rules need to be applied. Remember all the rules. See, if you just remember the rules and do not put them into practice, then definitely you will come to me and say that, ma'am, I forgot the rules. The only way to remember the rules till the exam and during the exam is to do continuous practice. Practice a lot, it's going to help you to improve in your work. Now let us move on to certain situations where you might feel when you read the sentence that even without the blank, my sentence is complete. There might be certain situations where when you read the sentence with the blank, you might feel that this blank is not needed in this sentence. Even without the blank, the sentence is complete. Now, for example, you might be given a sentence. For example, he is dash lazy. This could be given to you. When you read the sentence, my sentence is he is dash lazy. You might say that even without the blank, the meaning is being conveyed. He is lazy. So why at all this unnecessary blank has been given to me? In all those situations where you feel that the blank is unnecessary and the sentence can be completed even without filling in the blank, in most of such situations, either a modal, okay, or an adverb or an adjective is going to be filled up. Like for example, here we can say he is very lazy. We can say he is so lazy. He is excessively lazy. All these will make it correct. Here, very important, if you find any unnecessary gaps, try to fill in the following. Try to fill in the following. Out of the four options that are given to you, see the four options and see which one is an adverb or see which one is a modal and try to fit in that one. And I'm sure it's going to fit in. Now see here, they would pay the bills. Okay, if I even remove the word would, then they pay the bills makes sense. But see your four options. Suppose it has would. Suppose it has some other words, we will go with the modal. So if you find any unnecessary gaps, try to fill in the following. Number one, you have to fill in the modal. Number two, a word to change the emphasis of the sentence. You might simply need a word which will lay more stress on the sentence. And such words which lay more stress are words like to, words like so, etc. or very, these kind of words. See here, she's good enough to be a professional chess player. If I say she's good to be a professional chess player, it is making sense. But when I say good enough, this word enough is being used just to lay more stress. So certain words to lay more stress, certain modals, they could be needed to fill in the blank. The task is too huge to be completed single-handedly. This too is laying excessive stress. Modal or else, a word to lay stress, or finally an adverb. He is chewing something. Now here if I say he is chewing something and there's a blank given here. He is always chewing something. He is never chewing something. Here an adverb will be fitted in. So generally in those situations where you feel that a gap was not needed here, over there either a modal, either a word for emphasis, or else a word which is an adverb needs to be filled. When you see the options in front of you, try to look for these three words and try to fit them in. So your blanks, if they are grammar based, how you have to tackle them, I just discussed that with you. And now I shall move on to how to fill in blanks which are not related to grammar. Either your blanks will be related to grammar or they are going to be related to vocabulary. And now I have finally moved on to blanks related to vocabulary. Now let us take a look. When the blank space is not related to grammar, when the blank space is not related to grammar 101%, it is going to be related to vocabulary. Only two kinds of blank spaces are given in your close test. A few gaps may demand a vocabulary item consistent with the topic of the text. As I have always been saying to you, in a close test, you have to fill in those words which will make the whole passage meaningful. You have to keep in mind the whole passage. That is why I told you the tone is extremely important. Now see here, the Indian Republic was officially dashed on the 26th of January 1950. This is my blank space which needs to be filled. The Indian Republic was officially dashed on the 26th of January 1950. Was it renounced? Was it published? Was it inaugurated? Or was it born? Now these four words are given to me. To fill up the right word, you need to know the correct vocabulary. Renounced means give up. A person has a right and he is giving it up. So if you have a little knowledge, on 26th January 1950, the Indian Republic was not renounced. Published, publishing is used for books, etc. Publishing is used for books. Inaugurated, inaugurated is used for a building. On the very first day, we will say that the building was inaugurated. That is the meaning of inaugurated. Can we use born for a country? Yes, we can use born for a country. The Indian Republic was officially born on the 26th of January 1950. My correct answer is going to be C. Let's take a look at another one. This was purely related to vocabulary, where you needed to know the meaning of the four different words. Now here, a word which is part of an idiomatic expression. Sometimes certain words can be given in the blank space, which are a part of a phrase, which are a part of an idiom, etc. Let's take a look here. For heaven dash, I beg you to tell me exactly what happened. For heaven's sake, for heaven's sakes, for heaven's sake, or for heaven beware. Now, what do you mean by beware? Beware means to be alert. So when you look at the four options, this is the first one to be eliminated. For heaven's sake. For heaven's sake is a phrase when we ask somebody to tell us something or to do something for the sake of God. It's an idiomatic expression, and here out shake means to shake, to tremble, etc. So here, S-A-K-E, sake, this is going to be used. So to solve close tests, there might be certain situations where you need to know a little bit of your idioms and phrases also. You need to know your idioms and phrases, and that will play an important role. Let us move on. Sometimes the blank space which is there, it might require you to have a knowledge about pairing of words. pairing of words, certain words go only in pairs. They go only in pair. For example, I say he moved heaven and dash to find his parents. He moved heaven and earth. Heaven and earth go together. Okay. Now here, a true friend will be with you. Here we have be. A true friend will be with you in wheel and dash. Now we need to know what is the word that goes with wheel. Is it woes? Is it woe? Is it whose? Is it oh? Now in this sentence, a true friend will be with you in wheel and woe. This is going to be the answer. Wheel and woe. That means a true friend is going to be with you through all your happiness and joys. Okay, he will forever be with you. So out of these four options that are given, woe is going to be the right answer. So you need to know the right pairing of words also. You need to know the right pairing of words. You need to know the idioms and phrases. You need to know vocabulary. And besides that, the last most important point which I would like to make here is, in order to score well in the vocabulary section of your close test, you also need to have a good knowledge on phrasal verb. Next, very, very important knowledge of phrasal verb. A word which is part of a phrasal verb. You might get a blank to be filled up, which is a part of a phrasal verb. This whole thing could have been a blank. You could have been given touched here, touched off, touched on, touched upon, or touch at. Or simply, this part could be a blank where you need to fill up off, on, upon, at. Now, you need a very good knowledge about phrasal verbs if you want to score well in close test. A word which is part of a phrasal verb. Now, here the principal merely touched dash the topic. He touched off the topic, touched on the topic, touched upon the topic, or touched at the topic. Now, here we have to say touched on the topic. And what do we mean by touch on? Touch on means to merely mention something. It means to merely mention something. And as you can see in the sentence, we have this word merely. Therefore, on is going to be the right word. Please make sure that your phrasal verbs are in place, and all those students who are watching this video lecture, Pinnacle has made a complete series on phrasal verbs from A to Z. Alphabetically, we have done. All the phrasal verbs beginning with A, then B, then C, D, up to Z has been done in Hindi medium as well as in English medium. Go through them. Go through them. It will make a huge difference. You will feel more comfortable with close test. Since phrasal verbs are very, very important, let me give you a few more examples. Let's take the next one. Nurses have to pay attention because this patient may dash the virus to others through physical contact. He will pass off, he will pass OFF off, he will pass on, or he will pass on. Now here, have to pay attention because this patient may, this is not in the past tense, so passed on gets cut out. This cannot be the right answer. Now here, we have PAS pass and OF off, and PASS OFF pass off, pass on and passed on. These are my four options. So which one is going to be the right answer according to you? Which one? Here, pass on is going to be the right answer. When a disease, an infection, etc., it is transferred from one person to another, pass on is going to be used. Next one, the teacher dashed the list of words they have to look up in the dictionary. Read out, read loud, read up, or read to. You read to a person. I read a story to my children before they go to sleep. You have to read up the whole topic before you come for the class tomorrow. That means you have to go through the whole topic. That is the meaning of read up. But here the teacher read out is going to be the right phrasal verb. When somebody reads something, something for other people to hear in the morning, what happens in classes? Roll numbers are read out and everybody has to say present, ma'am. So here read out is going to be the right phrasal verb. Often I dash patients with my children. Often I run out in, run out of, or run out of. Which of? This is going to be the answer. Often I run out of patients with my children. When you say that you have run out of something, that means that thing has fallen short. Right now, there is a rumor in the country that people have run out of salt. People have run out of small denomination currency notes in the country after the recent decision by the government. So this is going to be the right phrasal verb. You will find plenty of these types in your close tests, plenty of them. And this is a very, very important section to be done if you need to score well in your close test. That was about what is to be filled in the blank. If it is grammar based, then how you have to tackle it. If it is vocabulary based, then how you have to tackle it. If you feel that nothing is fitting in, even without the blank, the sentence is making sense, then what could probably be fitting in? All that has been discussed with you now. Let us move on to the next slide. Finally, last of all, there are still students who mail to me and say, ma'am, if nothing works, then what? Even no matter how much I explain to them, they always have this question, if I feel that nothing is fitting in, then what is to be done? See, generally what is going to happen, you will have four options in front of you. One will be eliminated straight away. You will feel this is irrelevant because it might be inconsistent with the tone, or it might, on the very look of it, you will be able to decide this is not fitting in. There are going to be two options which are going to be close and which you will feel that they are confusing you. Two options are going to be close, and when you feel that all your methods of elimination have been exhausted, you have tried everything to come to the right answer, in that last situation, I will tell you, go by your intuition. You go by your intuition in the very first instance. That is not what you are supposed to do. If you feel it is grammar based, try to remember the rules of grammar. If you feel it is vocabulary based, then try to remember that. Still, you are not able to come to a conclusion. Then go by your intuition, because sometimes what happens is, while reading something, you might read something and that might stay in your memory. And when you put a little pressure on your memory, then you might be able to recollect it. And then that's the reason I say go by intuition. But even by your intuition, you are unable to come to a conclusion. Go by your intuition, but keep in mind the tone of the passage. Go by intuition, keeping the tone in mind. If you can't come to a conclusion, last of all, leave out the blank. This is what I will say. Leave out the blank. Why am I asking you to leave out the blank? As a last resort, you can leave out the blank, because if you do not leave it out, then there is negative marking. You have tried your best to come to the right answer, but you are not being able to come to the right answer. In such a situation, I would say you can leave out the blank. But please, this is the last resort. I am not suggesting, if there was no negative marking, I would have asked you to fill up anything. Okay. But since there is negative marking, therefore, as a last resort, I would say leave out the blank. This is what is there in this part three of closed test, this video lecture on part three. We have discussed so far what are exactly closed tests, what kind of closed test SSC asks, how are they different from banking, what is the importance of this section, and then how grammar-based knowledge has to be applied, how vocabulary is given. It is given in idioms and phrases, it is given as a direct word. Over there, it can be, what is the importance of phrasal verbs? Everything has been covered with you now. And even I have even discussed with you, what if nothing is fitting in and your brain is completely drained out and you have no option in front of you, then what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to leave it out. Now, whatever we have learned so far, we are going to put that into practical application, and I am going to solve closed tests for you. I will pick up every kind of closed test which has been given by SSC, whether it is story based, whether it is grammar based, whether it is vocabulary based, it is has a historical background, it has a political background. All kinds will be done with you till the last part of this series, till the 20th video lecture, so that nothing is left out. Okay, I wish you all the very, very best. And let me just remind you that this series on closed tests, it is a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program, specially designed program for SSC CGL Tier 2. I wish you all the very, very best. Thank you.